Happy August. My name is Larry Hryb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. This is, I think, show 603-ish. Sitting here with Jeff Rubenstein.
You had one job, Larry.
This is it. It gets so confusing because we have so many shows. You know how it is, right?
By the way, this is show 60. No, it's 605.
Is it?
The last show was 604. Look at the list. Oh, it goes 603, 604, 60. We're counting back down to one.
I just fixed it. We have a shared notebook here. Anyway, 605. Welcome. And unfortunately, as even within the first 30 seconds, Laura has failed to keep us in line because she's not here.
It is her job to count the shows.
Yeah.
Every day she comes in, she just starts from the beginning.
You and I can't even do that right.
Okay. Nope,
we are a fail. But anyway,
talkers.
Good to see you, Jeff.
Oh.
As always.
Yeah, thanks. You too.
We're here. We're rocketing through up here in the Northern Hemisphere summer.
Yeah.
Summer in Seattle. It's been very warm this week.
Yeah. Weather tweets are among the worst tweets.
Yeah.
Only lunch tweets are worse than weather tweets. We're tweeting, it's in the mid-90s here, and everyone's like, psh, it's in the mid-90s where I'm at, it's 186 degrees in Phoenix.
Yeah, now you grew up in Florida, so you're used to this type of heat, right?
Well, I mean, it's more humid there. The difference is, you live in Florida, you live in Arizona, you live in Texas,
mm-hmm.
you have air conditioning.
Yeah.
Or maybe a swamp cooler. Mm-hmm. I'm still not sure what that is.
Apparently, it's just a bunch of ice or cool water with a fan blowing over.
That would be an improvement to what most of us have in Seattle,
in
which
fact,
is
according to the New York Times,
nothing.
Two-thirds of the people in Seattle don't have air conditioning.
Correct. Really? Wow. So I'm one of those people. And that takes you back like 100 years. And so I feel like I'm in pioneering days, sitting in a puddle of my own sweat and just playing games and praying that my mind will go into the character, you know, and to the point where I don't feel hot anymore. Of course, it'll all be over soon. And by that, I mean the weather, not just like all of it.
Well, let's get to what we're playing, Jeff. What are you playing?
Oh, yeah, sure. So it's been a couple weeks since we last spake.
Yeah, since we last got together.
And a couple good games. Interesting things have come out in that
Quite
time.
A few, actually.
One of them is What Remains of Edith Finch.
Oh, that's a good one. I finished that one. I know you did, too.
I did. I got the 1K on that one. So I think it's interesting. You interviewed Ian Dallas from Giant Sparrow last show. And like he was saying, I think the more you know about the game, you shouldn't know too much about the game going into.
Right.
Suffice to say, you largely play a young woman learning about her family. Actually, located up here, not far from Seattle.
In the Northwest
on Orcas Island.
Yeah. Have you been there?
Orcas I never have.
Oh, Orcas is beautiful.
So it's a place where I know people go camping or something like that. You have to take a boat to get there. So, you know, she has a very interesting family, and I'll just leave it at that.
Yep.
And it is definitely worth your time. I thought it was a really interesting game. Yeah.
It was one of those games, and you know, you go back and listen to the interview last week at the end, you know, it's you can't say too much about the story because you don't want to ruin it.
Yeah.
And it's the way they tell the story. This is some I tweeted this out. This is some next gen storytelling.
Yeah.
It's really creative.
I feel like if you play Gone Home and that's sort of like a first person, like you uncover a story, this takes it a step further. And there's some different mechanics in there, besides just walking around and reading or hearing stories or something. There is a part of that, but, it's really cool. I just really enjoyed it.
Yeah. Can't say too much more about that. So I finished that as well. A lot of fun. Mm-hmm.
And then now for something completely different.
Yes.
On the polar opposite end would be Fortnite.
Right.
So a lot of people I've seen playing this.
A lot of people.
Yeah.
Game preview.
There's sort of like I don't know if it's part of the game preview program specifically. I mean, it has achievements and all that, but the game is, it is in an early stage. It's not 1.0 yet. But that being said, the combat's very polished. So the way this game works is like, you build up a base.
Yep.
It's... kind of like, I don't want to say Minecraft. Like if you were to boil down Minecraft, at least the survival mode, and Fortnite to like their base essentials, you build all day and you fight all night type of situation.
Yeah, I've heard it described as Minecraft meets Horde mode.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good way of putting it. It is a lot different than either. I've played hundreds of hours of Minecraft and Horde mode for that matter. And it does, I think, distill a number of the interesting elements of that. But if you just want to fight, you don't want to be much of a builder, you can, you actually spend a ton of time scavenging, going through and, you know, harvesting materials out of cars or houses or hidden things. There's some interesting stuff
garbage
there.
Garbage cans.
And there's a, you know, the characters look very interesting. Even the zombies are kind of cute. Very Pixar-ish. Or it kind of reminds me, the visual style, almost of like The Incredibles a little bit.
Okay. I'll buy that.
There's a bit of that, right? Yep. So, I think it's a pretty interesting game. There's a lot of people are streaming it, so it's worth taking a look on Mixer, Twitch, or YouTube, wherever it is you consume your content.
Yeah.
Definitely having a lot of fun with it. I think they're going to be continuing. Epic's going to be continuing to work on the game, and I will say that there's like when it comes to like the crafting and actually really like resource management, there's so much there. There's so much to it. The skill tree is huge.
Oh, it's massive.
There's a lot to learn. So I'm waiting for like really good guides to come out. I've been watching some YouTube vids on people who break down, oh, this is a great way to find this. And there's tons of loot. I do enjoy the loot box mechanic.
I know you do.
It's llamas.
Who doesn't?
You hit llama pinatas with a sword.
And sometimes your bat bounces off.
Yes. Bink. And then it turns into like silver. Yeah, I thought that was
gold.
Really, yeah.
Yeah, it was a cute touch.
That's a very cool mechanic. So definitely a game I think people are going to be playing for a long time, much like the other game we're playing for a long time, and that's Overwatch.
Right. Of course, that goes without saying.
So we had to go back there.
To get ready for?
Well, we're getting ready for summer games.
Yes.
But since the last time we spoke, Doomfist
has joined made an appearance.
And unlike, I would say, when the previous characters, Anna and, oh my God, help me out here.
There's Sombra.
Sombra, thank you.
Yeah.
When they joined, and everyone jumped in for like 2 days, and then some people really like Anna and Sombra, and most people don't. You go plenty of matches where you don't necessarily see one of the guys.
Right.
Every match I have played in the last week has had at least one Doomfist, and usually two.
Yep.
I think he's...
You played Doomfist. I haven't played him in a match.
It's hard for me to get. I played him one time in a match.
I think I did too, yeah.
And I think it was during Survival, and I did get a kill. Definitely, there's a lot going on there. I feel like he's kind of like if Ryu from Street Fighter Joy. He has a dragon punch. You can kind of almost spam special moves. Obviously, high-level players play a lot differently, but I feel like he's constantly moving. He's constantly jumping into the air. He gets his ultimate, it seems like,
he comes out of nowhere.
Or 7,000 times per match. So I'm curious how they're going to end up balancing him, but he's definitely, I would say, the most popular new character added to that game in a year plus since it's been out.
Right. Yeah. Rock on.
So playing that, and then one other thing is PUBG, PlayerUnknown's Battleground. So something they had, we know it's coming to Xbox as announced
at
E3.
Yeah.
But this week, they, I guess, Brendan Green or Blue Hole, the people that work on this, they announced that they were going to be supporting the Xbox controller on the PC version of the game.
Yeah.
So I fired it up.
When is that? Is that out yet?
It's in the test servers. Actually, I think it hit the normal servers
now.
Slightly before we... Yeah, so by the time you hear this. You know what? I got a kill. Got my first kill.
Yeah, you did.
And now, you're still playing in controller versus people playing in a mouse and keyboard environment. And look, I'm not going to be sniping 360 no-scoping people from across the map.
And we're not going to wade into that religious debate.
No. But the bottom line is I'm trash with the keyboard and mouse. So, at least when it comes to like navigating the space and looting things.
I think it's part of it's the inverted issue.
It's working for then maybe. Maybe it's just lack of practice. So, I was playing my first one. I was sort of messing around on like, there's this lobby screen at the beginning. And I was just trying to test out the controllers or the buttons mapping the way I want them to. And then it jumped into the game and I'm like, all right, I'm just going to play it. I'm not going to bail out.
Right.
So I'm in the plane, I dive out, I'm by myself and I'm like sort of orienting myself with the controls and I end up finding a shotgun. And I was like, actually, this is good. If I'm going to be using a controller versus a mouse and key, I'm not going to get into a sniping battle across the map that will destroy
accuracy.
Me.
Right, so...
But a shotgun is a shotgun.
That's
so
fair.
I'm sort of towards the edge of the map. I'm running. I'm just trying to get into the circle so I don't get firebombed. And then I sort of stop at the crest of a hill and I'm looking around. Like, is there any motion? Because I'm going to have to get the drop on somebody. I only have a shotgun.
So you hit the D.
And then
the
I see just a bit of movement.
Okay.
About 10 feet in front of me.
About 10 clicks.
There was 10 feet.
10
yes.
feet.
I don't know what a click. A kilometer?
Kilometers.
Prone, a sniper laying down, facing the other way. And oh my God, I just like, there's just like time slowed down. Yeah. My salivary glands kicked in. Yeah. A little bit of drool.
You brought the weapon up.
Heartbeat. And I just, I walked up. I didn't even aim down the sight. I got my first kill.
Did you just casually Javier Bardem style walk over to him and go boom?
Yes, I know. This is where I was like, I need emotes. So, you know, I got that first kill. And at this point, there's like 46 people left out of the 100.
Oh, so you made it pretty high.
And I'm like, oh man, this is my chance to get top 10.
Right.
Because I seem to be away from
this
everyone
is your
else.
First
everyone's
time doing, playing.
This is my first time playing like with a controller and first time ever playing solo.
Right.
And then and then I go about 10 feet and then
time slows down again.
No, literally that's my computer shutting down because I brought it upstairs. Like in normal.
Oh, no.
This is a laptop. These gaming laptops, love them. You need to have them plugged in pretty much all the time.
Your battery ran out.
I had brought it upstairs just to test out the controls. I didn't expect to jump into a game.
No.
So as far as I'm concerned, my player never died.
Right.
They just sat out there on the edge of some village.
He just went limp.
Everyone else killed themselves, and I must have finished first.
He went limp mech style.
Exactly. I have no choice but to assume that I won that one.
Oh, wow. That's terrible.
Yes.
Well, we'll have to play him, and I've been looking forward to coming to the console, and, you know, I make no bones that I am not an expert with mouse and keyboard, so maybe that's
one. You know, we're going to have a lot of fun with this one.
Yeah, I know.
So tell me, what have you been playing?
Well, you know, it's pretty much everything you've gone over. We talked about, I checked out Fable Fortune. It's now in game preview.
Xbox One and Windows 10.
Yeah, The Long Dark. I'm checking out the Path of Exile beta.
Ooh, PoE.
Yeah, doing that. Of course, that's always a lot of fun.
That's kind of like a Diablo-esque
yeah,
game.
Yeah, very much so. So yeah, one that I tried was Canadian Football 2017.
So tell me, how does it compare to American football?
It's a different game.
Yeah. More polite. Sorry after every tackle.
Apparently, you know, what someone said on Twitter, and I haven't gotten this far because I booted it up and then I had to run. Apparently, instead of Gatorade, there's Tim Hortons.
Ooh.
And every game ends in a tie.
So. Are there any Canadian stereotypes we didn't?
I know.
We didn't go on. We should just.
Some of our good friends are.
I know. I know. I'm up there all the time.
Anyway, so I'm playing that course. What Remains of Edith? Edith Finch was great, so that was a good one. So we're playing a lot of stuff. I want to have a little bit of a programming note here. We are in August, and between holidays and vacations, Laura's out, Jeff's out, I'm going to be out for a week. We're probably not going to do another show until PAX East, PAX Prime, whatever
PAX
it's
Prime.
PAX West,
PAX
whatever,
West,
whatever
yes.
It's called now. We'll be there on that Saturday like we normally are.
Yep.
So we'll record that and we'll put that out. So just in case, we probably won't have a time to get into the studio again because of the vacations, but I wanted to make sure that I signed off properly and let people know what's going on, Jeff.
I'm going to miss you.
You know, I was down at Comic-Con last week.
Yeah, I do know that.
That was a lot of fun. I did Comic-Con. I was there.
You were with Terry Crews. You sat at a table with Terry Crews. You took a great picture with him as well.
Yeah, I'll tweet that out probably closer to launch. I'm sitting on, I want to save that one for the launch crack.
Okay.
We had a lot of fun. Terry and I had moderated the panel. And that evening I did the, what now apparently is an infamous stream.
Infamous was the word I was going to be going for.
From
let's start with the positives. You got to spend an entire evening with Janina Gamertag.
Oh, she was delightful.
She's awesome.
In fact, she and I have been emailing back and forth. We've been talking about a few projects, but she's great. And, you know, there's a lot of people there. Met with some of the guys from Stranger Things. We saw that trailer breaker.
Oh, that looks so good.
Yeah, we saw that one coming out.
I love how it starts in an arcade.
Right?
Yeah.
And then they got the old Vincent Price.
Yes, that's right. Thriller. Yeah, that's a I'm going to link to that trailer.
So we got that. One of my favorite moments, and I mentioned this to you, is I was at this event in the stream, and I think Janina was on, or somebody was on, and I was stepped away to get some, check out the chat room and whatnot, and Zach Penn comes up to me.
Zach Penn, director of...
of the E.T.
Of the E.T.
The Atari.
But I think people are hearing, if they're hearing his name now...
Right, they're like, wait a minute, I know that name. So he comes up to me, I'll explain to you in a minute. So Zach comes up to me. He was the gentleman who wrote and directed the that was one of our strangest trips Jeff and I have ever taken. We went out to Alamogordo, New Mexico.
Yes, we did.
And we unearthed those Atari cartridges. And Zach comes up to me and says hello, gives me a hug. He says, hey, great to see you. He says, I want to let you know that the Atari dig we did was one of the greatest projects I ever worked on. I'm like, you worked on a lot of stuff, really? Because he tells me, because of that, he met Ernie Cline, who was the author of Ready Player One.
Mm-hmm.
when Ernie was shopping his book around Hollywood, apparently he wanted Zach to co-write the screenplay,
which is crazy.
So Zach is writing the screenplay or co-writing the screenplay. Who is, of course, directing it is
Steven. Zach Penn.
No. Directing.
Oh, Steven Spielberg.
Steven Spielberg. So, so the fact that we were in this desert in this landfill in Alamogordo led him to a gig with Steven Spielberg. Anything can happen, folks. Anything can happen.
That was so crazy. Yeah.
But yeah, I had him on. I think he was the last guest of the night.
I feel like we missed our big breaks, you know? I remember when Ernie Cline, and I didn't know who he was at the time. Right. I had not yet read Ready Player One. I remember him driving by.
In his DeLorean.
In his DeLorean, which he had the gold wing doors. Up, he had up.
Yep.
And he was blasting the E.T. theme. Yeah. Or maybe it was... might have been like the Raiders of the Lost, some John Williams score.
Some, which is always
very
epic.
80s. Yeah. And we're like, what just happened? And
he's got this beautiful car in the middle of a landfill.
You knew who that car belonged to, right? No, DeLorean?
Who was it? Was this, I don't know.
That's it. The writer of A Game of Thrones.
Really?
Yes.
Why did he get rid of it?
George R.R. Martin. So apparently, it might have been in the documentary. He like went out because George R. R. Martin lives elsewhere in New Mexico and like Santa Fe
lived in
or
Austin.
Something. No, he lives in New Mexico somewhere. Okay. And I don't know how conducive it is to finishing your sixth book. Maybe he should move somewhere with worse weather.
Right.
So he stays indoors, finish that book, please. Wins a winner. And yeah, he went there and he borrowed the car from George
right.
and then drove it down. I guess they're friends.
Was that his? So that was his.
So that
car.
Was George R. R. Martin's.
Oh, I didn't
DeLorean.
Know that. Anyway, so go back and watch the. Can we link off to the Atari? I'm sure it's on Netflix by now.
Yeah, yeah. What was it called? Game Over.
Was. God, it was so good. That was. Do you remember that? That was the weirdest thing. I'm like, Jeff, we're gonna go.
Oh, that was.
We had to transfer. Remember, we were sitting at the tarmac in L.A. Yeah. The whole journey was just. It was just once in a lifetime.
It looks like it's on Netflix, so I'll link out to that.
Anyway, so that was So it was great to be down there at Comic-Con and all sorts of fun like that. A lot of stuff coming out of that with Crackdown related. You know, there's a lot of news going on. We've got some news here, Jeff. I know you've got some of the news headlines in front of you. Why don't we bang through this real quick? I want to just remind folks, even though we're not going to be doing a show, you can always catch up on the news at my blog at majornelson.com. You can follow me on Twitter at Major Nelson, of course, this week on Xbox, which airs every Friday on your console. And I try
this one's looking like a good one.
Try to put it on Twitter and so forth. Which one?
All right, we're just commenting on how good the lighting looked this week.
Oh. Okay.
As they were editing.
Oh, the show. Yeah, with the show. I know.
You look radiant, Larry.
Oh, well, it's not me.
It's you have that summer glow.
It's the post-production.
Yeah, so, that too.
Anyway, let's go through the headlines real quick
so we can get people on the way. So something you may have seen is that Xbox is joining forces with this is where you put the bell ringing sound
ding,
in.
Ding, 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 ding.
Or more like gong with Taco Bell.
Okay.
To bring the Xbox One X to fans. So starting at the end of the month, August 31st, Xbox and Taco Bell are going to be combining to give you the first chance to win the Xbox One X. You buy this $5 box.
You like your quesarito, right?
Your
churro.
I'm a big fan of the... what's like the double taco where it's like the regular taco and that has the bean burrito around it, like the soft, the double whatever. And I'm a chalupa man as well. Okay. Oh, no, it's really good as the Doritos Locos. I'm hungry now. Doritos Locos taco. It's something that I feel like, you know, once a year,
I'm like,
this is happening. I'm getting my Doritos Locos taco.
Okay.
So good.
Okay, once a year.
Anyway, so, you know, we'll link out for some details, but basically the Taco Bell $5 box will have a code that you can text to win the Xbox One X. We're going to be giving away quite a few of them. I guess we actually partnered for the original Xbox way back in the day.
Yeah, way back in the day.
So we are
Taco Bell. So check that out. You can take a look at that.
Yeah,
so.
we'll link out to that. Three new controllers
were
revealed this week as well.
Yeah. We'll have those on the show, and I've put them on the Instagram.
Yeah. I don't know which one's... My favorite out of these three is the green-gray, where it's kind of understated. It's a grayish controller with dark gray buttons, but underneath it, there's like this, you know, neon green sort of color to it.
It's nice.
It looks good. I know our good friend Graham poked in from his annual leave to weigh in and say the Volcano Shadow Edition was his favorite. There's also Patrol Tech. We had a different tech controller that came out recently, but it was very textured.
Black and whatnot.
And
gold,
yeah, right. And so we have another one in that series. So we'll link out to all the details, but I think the green-gray, feel like that's your...
I actually really like that. Those are nice. It just reminds me of old Xbox colors.
Yeah, exactly. Right, there's something... Right. That, I mean, yeah.
Classic. Classic.
I do like that.
All right, what else we got for news?
It's more like Xbox 360. It's almost like the Xbox 360 controller.
Yeah.
Yeah, anyway. Minecraft. So there is we talked about our Better Together update. I believe that was also talked about at E3, and where the goal is to be getting to unify our versions of Minecraft across console and mobile and Win 10.
Here
so,
and there and everywhere.
So it is in now. It's in beta. So it's something that right now it's rolled out for Win 10 and Android. It's going to be coming to Xbox One soon. So it's something you're going to want to take a look at.
Yep.
If you're really big into it and you want to get a hold of it now, I'm going to link out to the Minecraft.net entry on that, and you can find out more about the Better Together beta.
A lot of people play that game.
This was a cool thing. One of the more, I would say, Forza Horizon 3 has had some very interesting sort of crossovers.
Yep.
And first, it started off with the Warthog,
yep,
which was probably one of my most used vehicles in that
right
game. Definitely good for the Outback. And the second one was, of course, the Hot Wheels
right
expansion, which was phenomenal.
They have fun with it.
This one I was not expecting.
What?
This one, I feel like I came up with this idea, but I'm sure I didn't.
Really? Did you?
Maybe it was in my mind. And that is the Final Fantasy 15 Regalia.
Right.
Which is the big car that Noctis and crew drive throughout the world, is coming to Forza Horizon 3. In fact, it's there now. And if you're someone who had Final Fantasy 15 on their Xbox One, you should check your Xbox messages. There should be messages, system messages that come from Xbox. So have a code, you hit a button, you download, and you will have the Regalia. So it is available, and if you haven't played Final Fantasy 15, it's within the game as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's something you can get, and it's free. So no reason not to. I'm curious how it's going to handle, because this car is like 20 feet long. It's like
right,
the Uber Cadillac.
Yeah.
Like a Maybach and then some. But it is, you know, one of the characters almost in the game.
Yeah.
So I'm curious if you can bring the hood down. The roof down. I'll have to check that out.
Ooh.
Anyway. Now I guess we can talk about games.
Yeah. By the way, don't forget, there's a demo up for EA Sports NHL 18. It's got this great 3v3 mode we should check out.
Oh, really? It's like sort of like back in the day.
Yeah,
yeah,
exactly. So we should check that out. But let's go through that. That one just came out like right before we started recording. So you
okay
should go to my blog, majornelson.com.
I could use the feelings of ice right now.
Yeah.
Just cooling me down right there. Better than AC that I don't have. Tacoma.
Yeah.
So this is a game that we've been talking about for over a year. It is from the Fulbright company, the people that made Gone Home, and this is really their follow-up to that. And it takes place in a space station in about 100 years from now, 50, 80 years from now, whenever we're going to be in space.
Right.
Can't happen soon enough. And so that is, I think it's another game where the more you talk about it, the more you give away. So
yeah.
I think that a very narrative-driven game. So Tacoma is available now. It's out on Xbox One now, and it will be coming to Windows 10 at some point down the line as well.
Mm-hmm.
The Long Dark.
Yeah.
So this is a game that was in game preview. It was one of the very first game preview games. And it has hit 1.0. The achievements are up and ready to go.
Yay!
And it is also an Xbox Play Anywhere title. The Xbox One version is available now. Windows 10 version will be, again, released at a later date.
Yep.
But a pretty brutal survival game, from what I'm told. And another game that has really caught my eye that I'm planning on playing this week is Shadow Tactics Blades of the Shogun. So it looks kind of like it's a tactical game taking place in like Edo era Japan.
Yeah.
And you have like a samurai who's like the more like the one that can kill people like aggressively. And then you have a woman who blends in as a villager and anyway, a couple of different types of soldier types that can go through. And there's a really cool trailer. Actually, I'll link out to it because it really,
please do.
Definitely. It caught my attention. So someone who enjoys XCOM and games like that, I think there's more of a real-time element to it. It might be worth your attention. That's Shadow Tactics Blades of the Shogun. And one last new game that actually, if you're an Xbox Live Gold member, is free for you, is
free.
Slime Rancher.
Free. You like free, right?
I like free.
Who doesn't like free?
I like
free
slime.
Yeah, well, there you go.
I've never been a rancher, so I'm going to be able to complete
the
circle.
From your days on Nickelodeon.
That's true. You know, Double Dare was originally a local show where near where I grew up in Philly, and like
just like Wonderama.
I don't know what that is.
Okay, look that one up.
I'll have to look that one up. But I always, you know, that was the thing we would talk about in elementary school. Like, I'm going to be on Double Dare. Like, I have a friend who's on Double Dare. He knows how to get us on Double Dare. Never came through.
Never came through.
But I was like, man, we could win $500. Imagine what you could do with that.
You could have won big.
Yeah. Could have changed the orbit of my life.
All the Capri Sun you could have drunk.
And it was a lot. If I could get the straw in without poking it all the way through to the other side.
Or squirting it out all over yourself. Yeah. Great design there, folks.
Capri Sun still exists, by the way.
Oh, it does?
Yeah.
Wow.
I was at a soccer practice thing for my kid, and someone brought Capri. I'm like, did you pull these out of a time capsule? Yeah, but apparently it's still there. And you know what? Still just as difficult to open.
They haven't solved that
problem. They haven't,
This is where we need to put the innovation. Okay, yeah. These are the problems we need to
solve. I think
we
fixed it. It was called the drink box.
Yeah.
And yet, Capri Sun's still kicking.
Yep.
They've said, we're not going to distinguish ourselves by the flavor, just by the frustration you have on the packaging.
Right.
Oh, wait, what's this? Capri Sun just came in as a partner sponsor. I love Capri Sun.
Yes. News desk brought to you by Capri Sun.
Yes. Yeah. And the other Xbox live game with gold for the first half of August, of course, is Bayonetta.
Yeah.
Which is a heck of a game, Platinum Games, and really just
feel like weapons in your shoes. This
you
is
do.
Your game.
It's guns in it's your the hands, only guns in your shoes. I believe the names of the guns have names.
Yeah, I do.
And I believe it was like parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme.
Right.
Which is all the ingredients you need to do to make a great Thanksgiving turkey. No. So every time it's Thanksgiving time, I can't help but think of Bayonetta.
I remember playing that game and my wife coming into my office and she's going, what are you playing? I'm like, I don't know.
Did you finish that game?
No.
So there's a level. There's a level late in the game. Spoiler alert. I mean, the whole game is, it's just so ridiculous. I don't feel like anything is connected from one to the other. You just kill everything.
Right.
But where you're on a missile that, like a nuclear missile that's like going, I don't know if you're going to Earth, it's going to Earth or
it's
whatever,
going
but, you're basically riding it like a rodeo, but then like other missiles are coming at you and you have to like fight. Basically the level takes place on top of like an ICBM.
Right.
Yes.
Yes.
Bayonetta. You gotta play it.
And it's free and it's waiting for you gold members right now.
Exactly. So. I remember playing this saying, we have reached peak.
Oh God.
Bayonetta, I suppose.
That is.
Hell of a game. I do love that game.
So.
Anyway, so that's your news. That's what's out.
Games of Gold. Of course, later this month, we've got Gamescom. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to attend. I've got a personal appointment I have to take care of. Jeff, you're not going out this year, right?
I don't know that I'm going to
I'm working
make
on some
it.
Videos for it, though, so you'll definitely see me there in some videos, but I will not be on site this year for Gamescom. Hopefully, I'll be back next year, but Xbox will be there. I know AC Bongos is going to be co-hosting the show. He'll be holding down the fort without me.
They're just not letting you back into Germany, right?
Well, it's you and I after that incident last year at the Jelly Bean store in the train station.
at the gummy bear store?
That's right, the gummy bear store.
We apparently, it is a hard limit. You can only have three samples. Right. I went for sample number four.
And no, you are
not going this year.
You're escorted out.
Yes. they take it seriously.
They're thrown out right there on the side of the dom.
Man, who is going to pick up gummy bears for me? Every year.
Who's my gummy bear mule?
Exactly. One year, I brought back 25 pounds worth of gummy bears. And you know what? It was worth it.
My wife loves those grapefruit ones.
Oh, they're so good. I'm a mango man.
What are the bear?
Baron Company.
Baron Company. Those are the ones that are just phenomenal. So,
we do need to sort this out offline. Ooh-wee. Who's going to be bringing them back for us?
Got
to
figure that part out. All right. So those are the news. So anyway, so as I said, we're not going to have a show for the rest of August. We'll be back when we come back for PAX West. We've got a special guest planned for PAX West. Can't tell you who it is, but you'll find out soon. Just follow me on Twitter. I'll tell you there. Do we have anything else? Otherwise, we're going to wrap the show up. This is a quickie because we wanted to take care of everybody and do a proper sign-off before we head out for our holidays vacation.
Well, no, I suppose that's it.
It feels short.
It does. Talk more, Larry. That's what you do. You vamp.
I don't want to just talk to talk. I mean,
Really? Really, Larry?
I don't. We'd love to see you at PAX West.
Yes, we would.
We'll have our panel up on that Saturday. I don't know. It's 1, 2, or 3. It's usually right in the middle of the afternoon.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's good or bad. Should we change?
No, I think it's good. You want people right after lunch and they want to take a nap. And you know what? We've got the perfect place for you.
It's cool.
Come on over. If we keep you awake,
it's
that
quiet.
Means we've done
we're
a
not,
good
we're
job.
We're not too loud. We're not too interesting.
No, but it's like instant feedback. We don't need to send a survey out later. It's like, oh, they woke up. So
are you getting really as fatigued by everything asking me about what I thought in surveys as is.
Yeah, especially when you just get to the website and they immediately want to give you a survey. I'm like, well, let me experience the site first, please.
Everybody wants to know what I think and what's going on. And I'm like, oh God, I just want to.
You're important, Larry. No, it's not me.
I know it's everybody. There's this data paralysis that everyone wants to get data in. And I understand data is good to drive decisions, but come on.
I don't know. What do you think about that fidget spinner you're fidgeting with?
Get off my lawn.
Yes.
Okay, there we go. I knew you were waiting.
It was a little bit of a. You're on one hand, you're complaining about something from the internet, and the other hand, you have a fidget spinner.
I feel this like, is Laura's fidget spinner. I'm gonna put it over there.
I feel like 8-year-old Larry and 80-year-old Larry are having a war,
of which
right
I'm
now.
Neither.
Yes.
So they're struggling. It's an internal struggle. We're yes. Anyway, we'll be back. We'll be back with PAX, which is when are the dates of PAX?
I can look that. I believe it's like September 1st.
Yeah, it's like right. Take. It's always right at the beginning of September when everyone rolls in from out of town and the weather's really nice. Everyone's like, oh, this is really nice in Seattle. It is, but it's usually the beginning of September.
Yeah,
right?
September 1st through 4th.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on in Seattle that week too. So
is Bumper Shoot going on?
Yeah, and they've got a pretty good lineup. So if you come, speaking from the city of Seattle, please come and bring your wallet because there's a lot to do that weekend. Yeah, Bumbershoot is the same weekend, which is like a big outdoor festival. It's kind of like Panorama or Lollapalooza or one of those things.
Come for the games, stay for the music.
Yeah, she's headlining.
Oh,
so
wow.
I'm curious to see her live.
This segment Odessa. Brought to you by the Seattle Chamber of Commerce.
Gucci Mane be performing.
Oh.
Spoon. Actually, this is a really good lineup. I'm gonna link to the Bumbershoot lineup. Okay. And you know what? And if you want restaurant recommendations, I'm gonna put together a whole thing for you. You gotta get out of downtown. You gotta go.
Yeah, that's always our PAX tip, is everyone always gets plugged up within the block around. All you gotta do is walk like 3 blocks north, south, east, or west, and bam.
Yeah. There's a whole city here.
There's a whole city here. There's a whole there's plenty of great places. There's the donuts.
Oh, you gotta get the Top Pot donuts.
We haven't been to Red Mill since you've moved here.
The burger place?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's another place we should try.
Okay.
Yeah. There's a lot of burgers. What?
First, we talk about weather at the top of the show. Now we're talking about food at the bottom.
We have become what we hate.
Yeah, exactly. Get off my lawn.
You're spinning fidget spinners. You're tweeting about the weather. Why are you still listening?
What's wrong with me? What is wrong with us? All right. You can find Jeff Rubenstein on Twitter. And where do you find you, Jeff?
At Jeff Rubenstein. It'll make it all about coffee.
And I can tell you this, if you get confused, you can find me at Major Nelson, and Jeff is one of the six people that I follow.
Yeah.
There's an explanation for everybody. I should still follow E? I don't know.
You should still follow E. He would be heartbroken if you unfollowed him.
No.
Like, is he bothering you?
No.
Or you just want to get that down to a 5?
I just want to get it to a 5. It has nothing to do personally.
I feel like
you're in a
one day you'll unfollow me.
Right. No.
And it'll be devastating.
No, it's stop it.
Will be,
it.
I will not be. I like will, when be, I did I will with, be inconsolable.
Like when I did it with Graham.
Yeah.
and I put the GIF up and showed me unfollowing. Click. So, all right.
Because you accidentally followed him, didn't
right,
you?
Right, right. I don't remember what it was. We were doing something.
It made his day. He was so excited. And you're like, oh, that was a mistake.
Zip. All right, gang. I've realized I've tweeted 5,126 photos and videos.
That seems like a lot.
That is, I'm sorry about that, Twitter. Wow. That's crazy.
Taking up all that server space.
All right, gang. We'll talk to you. We'll see you at PAX. You can hit us up on Twitter. We'll be checking that when we're traveling and taking our annual leaves and doing our own thing. But thanks for hanging out with us. Make sure to watch this week on Xbox every Friday, as I said earlier, on your console. When I'm away, Jeff, you're going to fill in for me.
Yeah, I'd be happy to do that.
If that's okay.
It's okay with me. To those of you who have functioning vision and hearing that will have to see and hear me, I apologize in advance.
We'll just, as we say in the business, we'll cover you with B-roll.
Yeah, there. Who's hosting? I don't know.
I don't know. It's a voice. It's
disembodied voice.
There you go. All right, gang. We'll talk to everybody next time, and have a great August, and we'll be back for PAX West. See you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
See you.
Oh!